Assalamu alaikum. Today we are going to shed light on some of the aspects of the play Progress, written by an Irish playwright, St. John G. Irvine. Peace hath her victories no less renowned than war. John Milton. Whenever we are talking about some play or a novel or any story, we have to linger on, or we have to take into consideration some of the important aspects. They are setting, themes, plot, characterization, and many other. So if we talk about the setting of this play, we must know that this play was written just after 1 year after the First World War took place, and there was a specific agenda, there was a meticulous planned effort by the author, because the author, keeping in view this setting, wanted to enhance or wanted to emphasize on the significance of the themes that we are going to discuss later. As we talked about this, that the setting was a remote village in England, and it took place just after the First World War. And when we talk about the characterization, there are only two protagonists, or there are two only main characters in this play. They are Mrs. Meldon and Professor Henry Cody, though there are two more characters, Gage, the gardener, and Hannah, who is a servant at the house of Professor Henry Cody. And there is a person who is no more, and his name is Eddie, and he is the son of Mrs. Meldon, and she is a bereaved mother. So, but there the story revolves around these two main characters, and they are Mrs. Meldon and Professor Henry Cody. Okay, now let us come to the plot. And the plot is, though it's very simple, but when you look at the underlying meanings, and when you look at the when you try to have the hair splitting expounding of this play, you must know that it has deep meanings, deep-rooted meanings associated with it, and it is not that simple that we think. It is not that simple as we take it. Okay, although the plot or the storyline is very simple, that Mrs. Meldon is a bereaved mother who just doesn't crow and wail and whine and just keeps complaining. She's not a fretful woman who just keeps complaining about her deceased son Eddie, who died in the First World War, but she epitomizes that the decency and how sensible woman she is, and she is a great paragon and perfect example, great illustration of how we can cope with the grief, right, in a perfect manner. So the plot is that Mrs. Meldon is a bereaved mother who has lost her son in First World War, and her only son Eddie, and her husband Tom couldn't take the news of their son's death, and he also died of a heart attack. So she's going through a lot, right? And on the other hand, on the contrary, she has her only brother, Professor Henry Cody. And Professor Henry Cody, who should empathize and sympathize with her, and who should really understand he should really put himself in her shoes right now, right at this moment, that what she is going through. But Henry Cody is very inconsiderate human being. He's a cruel, callous, ruthless creature who doesn't have any significance, who doesn't have any importance, who doesn't have any consideration for the grief, for whatever his sister is going through. So we have talked about the plot, the setting, and the characterization. And when we are talking about the themes, first, you must know that what do we mean exactly by themes. When we are talking about themes, what do we mean exactly by themes? So I told you that Mrs. Meldon lost her son And that was not exactly a pre-planned thing, but you know that what our this story revolves or this story hinges on the outcome of the warmongering. That there are many people who are really staunch supporters, great supporters of wars, and they are mostly politicians and statesmen. They really use the youth, they really use the soldiers, they really use the mob, they really use the common people for their own blasphemous, for their own filthy purposes. So war is just an outcome of all of this. And if we are talking about themes, war antagonism is one of the main themes, because Mrs. Meldon is really stern and staunch antagonist of war, because she has a loath, she has a feeling of enmity, animosity, hatred and loath towards war, because of course it was this war who that took her husband and son away. Then abolition of war, exactly, because in this play Mrs. Meldon is just really looking for something, is just really wants to secure something that must culminate or that must result, that must end up in this abolition of wars. But on the other hand, on the contrary, Henry Cody has come up with this disastrous invention, has come up with this invention that is resulting in jeopardy, that is resulting in disaster, that is resulting in detriment, that is resulting in destruction. And it was this bomb that he has come up with, and he has this proposal that this bomb will really expedite warfare. So when we are talking about revolutionizing warfare, that has been discussed again and again in this argument between this brother and sister, people thought that when he's talking about, or when he's considering revolutionizing warfare, this is something that people are going away, or people will get rid of this business of war. But on the other hand, on the contrary, or on the opposite, what is the problem? That Henry Cody is revolutionizing warfare by making it more, by mitigating it, by expediting it, by making it more expeditious, by making it faster. And what would be the outcome? What would be the result? That it would be deadly, it would be fatal, it would be mortal, that more and more people would be dead in just seconds and microseconds. Selflessness is another theme, because Mrs. Meldon, despite going through a lot, or despite facing many things in her life, she's so selfless. She thinks that she's not going to permit, or she's not going to let Henry Cody use this invention on others, because she knows even Henry Cody decrees, or even Henry Cody proposes, or even Henry Cody postulates this argument, or postulates this theory, that if you are stopping me, or if you become a hindrance in using this bomb, you are an enemy of our country. But Mrs. Meldon says that I am not an enemy of my country, I am not an enemy of humanity, because this doesn't console me thinking that if Germans have, or if French have killed my son, so I should kill Germans or French or Russians or whosoever. So no, none of the daughters should be taken away from their mothers, should be taken away from their fathers. Male chauvinist approach, if you go through this play, you will see that Henry Cody says that women do fuss, how women do fuss, and they are so messy, they are so fussy, and they are highly hypersensitive, they are emotionally bombarded creatures, and they are very, very they don't have any pragmatic or practical approach towards life. So that's why it shows that how what kind of male chauvinist approach Henry Cody has. Cruelty He's a cruel, callous, ruthless, impassive, phlegmatic person who doesn't have any consideration, who doesn't have any sensitivity, who doesn't have any feelings, who doesn't have any sensibility, who doesn't have any, anything towards, neither towards the grief of her, of his sister, nor towards the entire humanity. Greed is a part and parcel of this, of the character of Henry Corey, because you see, whatever he's doing, greed plays a pivotal or significant or important part in that, because he again and again says that whatever I am doing it for my own country, but on the other hand, he says that if the British government are going to pay me peanuts, I am going to sell it to another government. So this doesn't show that that he is an unpatriotic person, and whatever he is doing it for money and materialistic purposes. Of course, this shows that how self-centered and selfish person he is. He's an impassive person, and although he possesses heart, but that heart is as hard as a stone. Alright, I personally think that you must have understood, or you must have grabbed some of the important concepts of the play. Thank you.